صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
When someone would speak harsh words with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Bedouin Arabs, they would speak harshly to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, out of the mercy of Allah, he would repay them for what is better. He would smile back at them. And this is a very big example for each and every one of us. Today we are living in an extremely sensitive world, where people's emotions are high, people's feelings are stretched. You may have come across many individuals, when you say assalamu alaikum to them, they don't reply your salam. Why should we take that to heart? We should understand, we should give preference to our brother's feelings over than our feelings. We should try and understand the psychological state our Muslim brothers are in. If they look at you sternly, if they treat you harshly, you shouldn't think that it's directed at you. You should try and understand perhaps he's not having a good day, and make dua for your Muslim brother. Today we see the opposite. If someone looks at you in such a horrible way, and he treats you harshly, and he even uses vulgar language, na'udhu billahi min dhalik, we seek refuge in such practice. But if that's the case, we give them double back the bad character. We treat them badly as well. Who the hell are you to speak like this to me? I say assalamu alaikum to you and you're acting as if you're Arabic, you don't say wa alaikum salam to me. Does everyone remember the hadith about the woman who was wailing in the Qabrastan, in the cemetery? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam approached this woman and said, "O woman, please lower your voice." The woman shouted back at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiled. For Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he truly understood the disposition of that woman. He knew exactly what she was going through. So Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he smiled at him. This is hikmah. This is what we call wisdom. It is only through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah blesses an individual with hikmah. Many people may have knowledge. Many people may have studied 7-8 years. But pardon them and seek forgiveness for them. When we say fa'fu anhu, Sayyidina Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, pardon them. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fussilat, ayah number 33, idfa' billati hiya ahsan. Oh my beloved, repay with that which is better.